Everybody, today I'm back with another video that I want to share with you, a flip through of a single signature journal hair that I did create again to send off to Lindsay Zanor's channel. So if you are here from there, I appreciate your support. Let's go ahead and hop into looking at this journal. I wanted to make it more of a really fun light pink type of a journal, like romance, but also a love journal. So let's get into it. It is called Love's Journey. And it just takes you through, you know, being in love and what that feels like. Maybe what that means for you. Maybe it means loving your children or your grandchildren or your pets or traveling or flowers, a love for gardening. So you really can use this journal for any type of love that you may have in your life. Not necessarily just romance type of love. And I took apart a rose book here for this. And I liked that it had books here. And then this really pretty linen. And so this first page, we start off with a pocket. And then we have a journal card here that says ladylike, and there's some more rose paper, and on this one it's just an envelope, and it's got in a couple of letters from a scrapbook page that I took apart that you could use in your projects. You know, just thought it would be fun to include those in here just so the envelope wasn't necessarily empty, but trying to use up my bits and pieces too to keep it fresh. We have some birds. We're going to see hearts and this washi tape throughout the journal, as well as the same type of stamping. And this was a little bonus page. I wasn't sure whether or not I would use it. It's like turtle doves, I think, or something. There was two white birds next to each other, and I just thought that would be a really pretty little page here to write on. We have a floral image in the corner here. Nice Lindsay Zanor paper. I love this. I don't know which kit it's from, but I really like this paper. Lace scrapbook paper. We have pink vellum. I think I only have one more page of that left. I have a little tiny cluster here, and look how pretty it is. All it is a stamped image with a little birdie on top that I inked up with my pink ink with the lace. And it is on a napkin on top of music paper. And it really is such a delicate little page. And then I did some stamping off on there of some pink flowers. So super, super fun. But yeah, really easy and really effective. And it feels so soft. And then here we have a large tag, trying to keep with the pink theme. I did all pink inking. And this is a Prima paper postcard. Super fun. We have lined paper. We have a Paris page. This, I can't remember where this one came from. Scrapbook paper. We have a clock here, but not necessarily overly pink. You know, you don't want to do too much pink. And so I've incorporated a little bit of red because we have those bright red at the very beginning from those books, and then that heart. And you're going to see that heart again here in just a minute. So every time we have the washi, we have a heart, or should. If there's a cluster type of thing, you might just see washi by itself, but there's just a few little red hearts. And that's just to remind us that, you know, love comes in all colors. And I just like using, I use a heart doily. Really trying to stay with that theme. Love this butterfly and flower image here. That's a Lindsay Zanor, backed with some pink paper. I have a little journal card here from, oh my gosh, I forgot her name. Victoria Designs. And it says, this is our happy place, again, with a little red heart. I chose Puzzle 100 because I was thinking like 100 days is like a big thing for a lot of people. And this is a day at the beach. And I just thought that was like a date. And then plus chemistry 101, like chemistry, romance. I just thought that was kind of a fun little play. So that worked out well. And then on here, this is actually a card that I got from something that I ordered off of Etsy. And I thought it was a really pretty little lady. So I wanted to include here. And then I just backed her with some lace. We have a little tab here. Hello, beautiful little bird. Red envelope. So that is, I only have two of these, so I have one left, and it's really red. So I wanted to have it in here because you're not expecting there to be red on the inside of that. That's the original envelope. So super fun. This is Lindsay Zanor paper there. So is this one. This is out of my flower book that I wanted to put in here because we have flowers, like a little flower girl. Oh my goodness. Thinking about like weddings and, you know, flowers and just little girls, like, oh, so precious. We have a journal spot there. And I didn't cover up the back of the calendar because some people like to write in there. And, you know, maybe they want to do their own collaging or whatever. There's a really pretty flower here, which is actually our center page. This beautiful flower. I have no idea what it is. Maybe it tells us. It probably did, and I probably cut it off. Like on the bottom down here. But yeah, so there's the center. We have houseplants. And I just tried to keep it pretty simple. There's some more of that washi tape on either side of the page. Lindsay Zanor. There's another little red heart in the center of a flower. I thought that was a neat little way to use the rest of that envelope. And then I stuck washi tape on here because I didn't know if this was going to end up like getting stuck to this paper. So I wanted to cover that one up. And then of course the rest of our word search there. And on this one, I just stuck a pocket and I sewed it down. This is tissue paper, Tim Holtz tissue paper, I think. And then I did a stamping on an envelope and it just tucks in there. So super pretty. And then we have some more washi tape with swans. This is a Lindsay Zenore paper. And I put this on photo paper, so it's really, really thick and sturdy and glossy. And it gives it a whole nother feel to the journal itself. And then I backed it where you'd be able to write, because you're not going to be able to write very well on gloss paper. There's the rest of our heart doily. And it says, love, 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 that is the soul of genius. Wolfgang and Mozart. So Wolfgang Mozart wrote that. And you can read about that. A princess actress. We have rose paper. So such a sweet little journal. I had a lot of fun making this. It really took me out of my comfort zone by adding in all of these pinks all in one journal. There's a flower down here. This is like gold texture paper. I don't know. I had it in my scrap box, so I decided to put it in here. And we have up here Choose Joy with a little banner and a flip out pocket. Yeah, so I hope that whoever gets this journal will definitely love it and fill it up with all of their favorite things that they do love and find joy with. I have a little card here, postcard, and I wanted to put this one from an image from a flower book. I thought it was really pretty. And then a really simple background here for a journal card, journal tag, I guess. It's really thick. I backed it up with some cardboard, so it's a really nice tag. You can also use that for a bookmark too. And then in here we have a Prima paper cut apart. And again, I used that same napkin and then pulled it in to the other side of that music paper. I thought that was such a pretty, fun, neat little idea. Vellum, then the lace. I added some labels here and there for you to have some fun with. Some more stamping. That washi tape with the other little turtle dove. The graph paper with another one, Let Your Dreams Fly. And back to the very end with the red and the green. It says Cherry Blossom in the Spring. Pink Cherry Blossoms Bloom song. So that is my little love journal here, and I hope y'all enjoyed watching the flip through of it on my channel. I hope y'all have a great rest of your day, and we will talk to you really, really soon. Bye, everyone.